Okay, so welcome back to this final part of the installation process of Pro Tools. And we are going to activate the license on your iLock License Manager. So head into your iLock License Manager. You should have already tested this. You should be able to log in fine. Really easy to use. Sign out there, sign in there. These are all the things that are connected to your computer. They are highlighted when they are actually plugged in. So I've got an iLock here called Buzz, and then the computer itself is possible to use for licensing. We haven't got any network devices, but let's come back to our main account and we're going to go into available. And what we want is our Pro Tools subscription. So if you double click on this, it will bring up the information about your Pro Tools subscription and we can choose to activate it. Click here. And what we're going to use is select the item and we're going to use the cloud. If you do have an iLock, I'm assuming most people don't. Sorry if I've assumed and you do, but you can put it on your iLock. In this case, we're going to use the cloud. So I'm going to activate that. Confirm that you want to use it on the cloud. Yes. Very good. Okay. And we can see the iLock manager getting that cloud up and running, saying, okay, here's all the things. We can reduce this down. We can see all of these things have been installed. Subscription. Now, just going to make sure that we have the plugin bundle that we installed as well. So we're going to do the same thing. So I can see here when it was issued, today's date, double click on it. We're going to activate this. It's going to say what item. We're going to choose the item and we're going to put it on our cloud license as well. Yes. Beautiful. So that's a load more licenses and we can see all those licenses just there. You can see all the plugins and we can see our Pro Tools subscription. So let's get Pro Tools open. Make sure it works. Oh, first time I've opened it. Authorize that. The installation process might be slightly different with Windows, but essentially, if you're using the Avid Link app, then it should be really, really similar. iLock License Manager is the same on Windows and Mac as well. And we are off. So there's a little warning here. Audio input for Pro Tools is disabled. So this is system preferences in a Mac. You might have a similar thing in Windows. Just saying it's not connected to audio input using that. And it's going to ask you, do you want to use this? Yes, we can use the microphone. So it means if your system is set up to see the microphone, like the one I'm using, it can access that hardware. Pro Tools goes through and it scans all of those plugins we've installed, make sure they're all working. It tests the video engine. And before you know it, we'll be in and ready to go.